Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to be sharing my night routine, lockdown edition. Now, I have already made a video about my morning routine, which is also a lockdown edition. So if you have not watched it, go give it a watch after this video because this video is in continuation of that video. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so before we get into the video, let me just explain my ideology of a night and morning routine, because a lot of people commented in my morning routine video saying that, you know, why are you showing morning routine till 5 p.m. Now, if you put some logic, if I were to show just the a.m. routine as my morning routine, the video will get over in 30 seconds because I wake up only at 10 a.m. So 10 a.m. se leke 12 noon tak, if I make a video which is just of 2 hours ka slot, I hardly do anything in those 2 hours. So that's why, according to me, my morning routine is till the sun is up, and the night routine which I'm going to share in today's video will have the time slot from say 5 p.m. till the time I sleep. Now that I've cleared all the doubts, let's start. So around 5 to 5:30 p.m. I get done with my shoot. Maybe Instagram or YouTube, I make it a point that I'm done by 5 to 5:30 max. And then I have to start working on prepping my content to post. Now, if you guys know me, you know that my upload time is 7 p.m. on YouTube on both of my channels. So it takes a lot of time to prep your content before it goes live. Now, what do I mean by prepping? So you have to work on the thumbnail, you have to work on, say, title, description, tags. So all of that takes around 40 to 45 minutes. So I start working on all of that at around 6:15, and then by 7 o'clock the video is live. Now once the video is live, I feel so relieved. So after 7 o'clock, it's my either nap time or workout time. Now it depends on like how I'm feeling on that particular day. So if I have worked throughout the day and, you know, I have edited on the same day, I take a nap for around half an hour to 40 minutes. Now let me just be honest about this, that I have been so bad these past weeks. I have not worked out at all, but I started doing it recently. It's been like 3 or 4 days that I'm doing it continuously, and I hope to do the same in the coming weeks as well. So if you are someone who does not know where to start from and how to start working out, just do like 5 to 6 sets of Surya Namaskar every day and you are good to go. If you want to work on your abs or your belly fat, you can go and search a lot of videos on YouTube. Just type ab workout for women and you will have multiple videos, like tons of videos on YouTube, and you can start working out. Now by the time I get done with my workout, it's almost 7:30 or 7:45, and this is the time I start unboxing my PR packages. Now everybody knows that, you know, delivery boys cannot come up, so all the delivery boys who come, they give it to my watchman, and the security guard say I go and collect it, or he comes up and gives it to me. So whenever they come, my mom sanitizes them, like uses a spray, sanitizing spray, and keep them away for some hours or sometimes some days as well, and then only I touch the parcels. So don't worry, I'm taking all the precautions. And after I have taken products out of the box, I again sanitize the products, keep them away for some time, and then start using them. Now after this, I would generally go and take a bath. I bathe twice a day because, you know, I'm either shooting or editing, and I just feel better if I take a bath at night as well. It just helps me to sleep better. But if it's my oiling day, then I will oil my hair first and then go and take a bath. Now a lot of people ask me that, why do you oil your hair before you go and take a shower? So I bathe with hot water. What hot water does is that it just opens up the roots or the pores on your scalp, and it helps the scalp to, you know, absorb the oil in a better way. Now in today's video, I'm going to be using this new oil which is launched by Mama Earth. This is the Bring Amla Hair Oil. So apparently it's written on this bottle that this is made with Shirpa process from Ayurveda, which involves heating mixture of more than 12 herbs in milk to absorb the potent of herb benefits.
Now they have come up with this Sherpak challenge where you can make this oil at home as well if you are interested. I'm inserting the picture of the entire process. So as you guys can see, there are multiple herbs needed for this process. And obviously I'm not gonna make it at home. It's so difficult to do it.
Obviously nobody has that much time to, you know, mix so many herbs and put it in milk and all of that stuff. And that's when this oil comes in handy. You don't have to do all of that vidhi for your hair. You can just use this hair oil and you're good to go. And to be very honest, I had not heard about this vidhi, like this Sherpak vidhi, and not a lot of brands are, you know, talking about this vidhi, so I was really intrigued. So I really appreciate Mama Earth for doing all the work for us and doing this vidhi and giving us the end result in a bottle. Now this oil is meant for intense hair treatment, like if you are someone who's dealing with hair fall or hair breakage or just brittle hair in general. It's gonna help you because it's meant for promoting the hair growth, preventing graying of hair and also strengthening the hair follicles.
They have also launched a shampoo and a conditioner and as well as a hair mask.
So yeah, if you are interested, you can buy these products on their website and you can use my code called as Mansi2020 to get 20% off. And I'm not gonna earn anything because of this code. This is just for you guys. But if you don't want to shop from there, you can also shop from Amazon and Nykaa. Slowly and steadily, we have to start supporting Indian brands. Mama Earth is an Indian brand. It does not have any parabens or silicones. It's like an organic brand. It is also certified by PETA as cruelty free. So yeah, there is nothing negative as such about the brand. After I've come out of the shower, it's skincare time. I am a big skincare fanatic. Now I am having some bumps on my skin because if you have watched my last vlog, you guys would know that, you know, I pulled a stunt. You have to go and watch that vlog and then only you will know what I'm talking about. So because of that, I've got a lot of pimples on my left cheek. So I am not doing a lot to, you know, my skin. I'm just using a face wash and some calming product on my face like calendula or aloe vera gel to just calm my face down, and that's it. I'm not gonna use anything else for my skincare.
After skincare, it's body care time. I am obsessed with smelling good all the time, even when I'm at home. If you guys want me to make a video on my bath and body products, then don't forget to let me know in the comments down below. Then it's some family time. Now that's my niece, as you guys already know, and she used to come every day before the lockdown started, but because of the lockdown now, she hardly comes once in 2 weeks. So whenever she comes home, I make it a point that, you know, I spend quality time with her. She's like a stress buster for me.
Now at around 9 o'clock, I have my dinner in bed. Now I know it's a bad habit to eat in bed, but trust me, I just cannot eat on a dining table. I don't know what is it with me. I always eat in my bed, maybe breakfast, lunch, dinner, anything. I sit in my bed and eat. But don't worry, I do not spill anything on my bed. So yeah.
So I was on the last episode of The Originals, and let me just say that I cried my eyes out when Elijah and Klaus died. Hashtag always and forever.
After my dinner is done, I either start binge watching something, or if I know that I have gotten a lot of mails in that particular day, I go and star mark every mail so that I can reply to them afterwards, because it's not good manners to reply to a mail at night, so like after working hours. So I just star mark the important mails that I'm supposed to reply to. And if I have some work pending, that is editing some video, or if I have some deadline, I start editing videos in this time after dinner. If I have a lot of editing to do, then the editing goes on till the time I sleep.
Now sleeping time varies every day, but I make it a point that I do not exceed 2 a.m.'s mark. I always sleep before that time.
Okay guys, I guess that is it for today's video. I hope you liked it. If you did, then do not forget to give this video a big thumbs up. Comment on what other videos you want me to do, and I shall see you in my next video. Until then, stay positive and stay happy. Bye.